Now I'm with the owner of Sir Cheesy, the one that I told you about that had me going ah! in the middle of the night to get a gourmet grilled cheese on the side of the road on Thomasville Road. But this is James Cullen, and you are the owner of Sir Cheesy. How long have you been doing food trucks?
I've actually only been running this food truck for about 6 months now. We opened right about the end of March.
The first question that goes through my mind is, whatever makes somebody think, I want to do a food truck?
Just the simple fact I couldn't find a job. This was the best thing for me to do. Just putting my cooking skills to work and starting my own business and doing it that way. Got tired of looking for work, so why not start my own business?
And that's a great attitude, especially in the economy the way it is right now. Now, how hard is it to get a food truck started? There's a food truck association here with how many food trucks in it?
We have the Tallahassee Food Truck Association in town. Currently, I believe it's about 15, 16 trucks that are members. I think there's a few more newer trucks looking to join as well. It's actually starting the food truck, the dealing with the state to get licensing and permits and all that is the easy part. It's finding the money to open one of these things and do them the right way.
Well, I would think that it would be an advantage for you that you can take it anywhere. You have different stations all over town. Tell me a little bit about where you have your truck at different times during the week.
Currently, we have somewhat of a set schedule. Tuesday nights, we can be found out here at Status Liquors, the food truck block party. There's usually 6 to 10 trucks out here at any given point. Friday and Saturday nights, we're in Midtown, out in front of Lucy and Leo's Cupcake Shop. And we're usually out there from about 10 at night to 2:30 in the morning for the late night bar crowd. And then Thursday nights, lately, we've actually been hanging out at Crew de Gras quite a bit. There's a kickball league in town, and they do a happy hour there. And they love to eat when they're done, so we go over there and hang out for a few hours and have a lot of fun with everybody. And
you can kind of stalk the hungry drunks, I would think, you know, when you do this.
Grilled cheese is just it's a great late-night bar food. It goes very well. That was part of the business plan.
Right. Had that in mind. So what we have here, you have, this is actually cheese fries. This is like everything in the kitchen sink. What all is on this? There's like bacon and...
The cheese fries are, it's our fresh cut fries that we do. And then we top them with cheddar and cheddar cheese and pepper jack. And then we crumble up some of the Bradley's bacon that we use. We can make them a whole host of different ways. We customize them all the time. One of our favorite ways is to actually do them with some goat cheese on them too. It's a nice creamy substitute for some of the other stuff.
Sounds really good. Now this one is called Jenny, but you said it's not from Forrest Gump. It's not like that Jenny.
No. It's named after my fiance, who's also co-owner of the business and everything. And the Jenny is probably our signature sandwich. It's the best one we make, I think. It is goat cheese, pepper jack, some prosciutto, thin sliced prosciutto with some strawberry preserves. And it's nice and creamy. It's got all the different flavor combinations. And it's about as perfect of a sandwich, I think, as you can make.
And you search for the perfect sandwich, I'm sure, the perfect grilled cheese.
Yes, and part of making the perfect grilled cheese is all using perfect ingredients, which, you know, is the reason why our stuff isn't the cheapest stuff in town. But when it's all fresh local ingredients, a lot of it is actually farm to table stuff. A lot of our ingredients are farm to table. So
I should call you Sir Porky, because you have one thing on the menu now that has no cheese in it. What's this right here?
These are actually our brand new. We just came out with them last week. It is a pulled pork slider. It's a slow-cooked pulled pork. We ran our pulled pork as a special about a month and a half ago, and people have literally been threatening to burn down our truck until we brought it back. So we've decided to start doing the pulled pork full-time now.
Right, you're like, hey, maybe we should make more of that, huh?
Exactly. These are slow-cooked pulled pork with some fresh southern tangy slaw on top. The coleslaw is made to order. It's pretty shredded. We shred it ourselves, but we don't add the dressing until it's actually ordered, so it stays nice and crisp. Gives the sandwich a nice crunch. We serve it on a Hawaiian roll, and the catch with these is...
Hawaiian rolls are a little bit sweet, right?
Yeah, the Hawaiian rolls have that little bit of sweetness. The pork has a little bit of sweetness, but it's also got savory components to it. And the thing we will do different each week for the pulled pork sliders is we're going to have two different barbecue sauces every week. Last week we ran a spicy and our spicy one and don't know what the other one was off the top of my head now.
But you're going to have two every you're going to have different sauces every single week, so.
Yeah, this week is cherry, and we did a different variant of the spicy again, and next week we'll have a mango habanero, and we have to come up with a second one still.
Good deal. Well, this looks delicious. Tell me a little bit, real quickly, about all the other food trucks that are here. They're all in your association, I guess. You've got Flip Smoke and Fry over here. And these guys are friends of yours. They're Ringo's Tacos that have the Americanized tacos. Tell me a little bit about the guys over here. We went around and did each one.
We have Eric. Eric over here from Leola's Crab Shack. He's got his new truck. Then we have Fat Max down there. Southern style food. He's pretty good. And then Red, White, and Blue one is the Great American Sandwich Station. Looking for a steak sandwich in town? Go talk to Kenny over there. Absolutely phenomenal. You're not going to find a better one anywhere else.
All right. Thanks, Jim. Well, now I have Ashley Paul here with me, and you have Tacos Gringos, right? And what we have right here is actually an Americanized empanada.
It's filled with our homemade three cheese mac and cheese. And just today, I made up a new sauce for it. It's going to be a garnet and gold barbecue sauce to dip it in. And these are all family recipes. The dough is made from Jason's grandmother's recipe from Spain. We hand make it, roll it out, we hand stuff all of them, press them, and fry them. So everything's fresh ingredients, homemade.
Awesome. So there you go, Americanized tacos at Tacos Gringos. Awesome. Well, tonight on The Spirit of Food, we have been right here on Tennessee Avenue. So come on out and enjoy it yourself. This has been The Spirit of Food on The Greg Tisch Show.